to the Senior Summit. We're leaving town, baby.
Hi, I'm Bonnie Francis, and we're here talking with Maggie and Beth today. They're going to be out at the Senior Summit, which is May 18th. It runs from 9 to 2 out at the 4-H Fairgrounds. And we wanted to talk to them about who they're representing, which is Sure Neurocognitive Health. Some of the things that are out at the summit, I wanted to mention that they're going to have all kinds of vendors set up. The Roratans will be selling food. There'll be demonstrations like scales and tails and line dancing and giveaways. You know, they have bags and things like that. So if someone has questions, what type of questions would they be asking you about services you provide?
So I guess people would have questions about, a lot of questions that we get are, you know, should I be worried about my memory?
Okay.
What would it be like if I came to your office and I'm concerned about my memory? What would the process be like? So we can tell people, walk them through the process, or if they're concerned about their mood.
So tell us at the table, if I come up there, what types of things will you have there available?
Well, we're going to have information about our services and what we provide to our clients and their families. And we're also going to have a mood screen available and a memory screen available and some brain games that people could play. So if people are concerned about their memory, we can kind of do a quick screen and then, you know, see if there might be something to be concerned about. Or if people are concerned about depression or anxiety, we can do a quick screen about that as well.
Okay. Quick screen. It's not the detailed thing. And I don't know, you know, with all the things that go around out there, but you might be able to do something off to the side if someone wanted to, you know, what are things that I should look for?
To look out for.
Yeah.
Right.
And I think it's also what we hope to do is help people understand our practice. We are a new practice. We've been in Easton now for just a year. We opened our doors just about a year ago. And, you know, we focus on the aging process. We focus on issues that the older adult and their families face when somebody has mental health issues, such as, you know, whether it be depression or anxiety or whether they have memory problems. And so it's helping people understand what we can do for them in our office and also to help them age better in the community.
Okay. So you talk to family members with the elderly, the senior member, or do you get more people? I know you're just a new practice, but are there more like phone calls from family members or from seniors themselves, I guess, is my question.
So yes.
I know, I was thinking yes, both.
Yeah. We do. We get both, you know, we get a lot of adults who are concerned about their own memory. They're concerned that they're maybe they're feeling a little depressed or down and that's impacting their memory, or they have these life changes. Maybe they've had some losses in their life, so they're not feeling themselves. You know, that's kind of those calls that we get from individuals. From family members, yes, we get calls and says, either from the spouse, it says, hey, my wife is, you know, she's just not herself. Her memory isn't as good. I hear you guys offer memory testing and treatment of memory problems. Or from the adult children, you know, mom or dad are doing X. You know, they're not remembering, they're not cooking as well as they used to, they're not as active as they used to be.
Right.
And they're not functioning as well in their home. Can you help us figure out what's going on? So those are the types of, we get both of those phone calls.
Now, I don't know if I heard this somewhere, if I read it somewhere, that when a person stays inside and doesn't have that social activity and stuff like that, that they lose track of like what day of the week it is and that type of thing. Is that something that is normal, that usually happens?
Can happen. I would be, I'm a psychologist at the practice, so I do neuropsychological testing that can kind of dig a little bit deeper.
Right.
Because lots of times people will say, oh, I don't need to know what day it is. But it can be kind of a masking where there might be more to be concerned about, and it's, you don't want to face that, so you just kind of say, oh, I don't need to know, you know, because I'm in, like you said, I'm retired, I don't need to know. So I always want to know more, because one thing, you know, is not necessarily diagnostic, but I always want to ask more questions, and because I'm a psychologist, probably do more testing to figure out, is there more to be concerned about? But I would say it can happen, where people lose track if they're out of touch, and that isolation isn't good in a number of ways.
Well, I would think there are skills or strategies that people can use. I mean, for instance, if that would happen to my mother, I would suggest, here's a calendar, cross off. And I know a lady that does that. Mm-hmm. Mike and I go in and visit in the nursing home, and she has a calendar on the wall, and she crosses off each day as it goes. You know, that way it helps her keep track of what the date is, what the day of the week is, those types of things that you want them to be able to keep track of.
Right, and that's something we do, is help our clients and their families develop strategies unique to that person to help maintain independence and functionality, and, you know, so people can carry on, you know, living the way they want to live.
So our goal, really, and when we talk with individuals, is to understand them as a person. What was their background? What were their strengths before? So you were a teacher, so, and you were an organizer, because you had to be. So we would use those strengths in helping you figure out how can you best deal with today's issues based on what you've been using for a lifetime.
Right.
Somebody else may have been a secretary, somebody else may have been a physician, or somebody else may have been a bricklayer. It's whatever their strengths are as an individual that can, they already have those tools, so it's reminding them of those tools and rebuilding them so they can best stay in their own home.
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the reason I mention that date is because I know sometimes doctor's appointments come up or other things. So it's real important. One of the ladies that I call, I know she loses track of days. And it's like, it's Monday today, and the date is, I usually, every time I call her, tell her.
Kind of that reorientation.
Yes. I usually make my calls Mondays and Tuesdays. This is Monday, and this is the day. Just because she is at home, she is a shut-in, does not drive, and so she does not have a lot of contact.
And that's one connection. Yeah.
And that service that you provide is so critical to her, because she may get very depressed because she's alone. And that's the thing that we see with people that get isolated. They don't talk to people all day. You know, they may watch television, or they may read books, or listen to books on tape, or whatever they do during the day. But that contact with another human is really critical. So that is really wonderful.
Well,
that you do that.
I wish there were more. I mean, we only make like a dozen phone calls, and I know there are a lot seniors out there that are in their home and just don't get a phone call, and and could use someone to say, hey, how are you doing today?
Right, and that's why I think the Senior Summit is great, because it does help spread awareness about what is out there. So we're excited to be a part of that. Just to, one thing we want to do is help, you know, we want to help our clients, but we also want to connect them to other resources, you know, that can be helpful to them. And so that's why it's good for us too, to learn, you know, everything that's out there.
Yeah. Give us contact information if someone doesn't make it out. We want them to come out to the summit. That's what this is all about. But if they don't make it out there, and they see us on TV and say, hey, I need to find out more about that service. How do they get in touch with you?
So they can call our office at 443-746-3698. I'll say that one more time, 443-746-3698. We also have a website, which is snhealth.net.
Okay.
And they can learn more about our practice and some of the things that we're doing. And they'll get in touch with our administrative assistant, Erin, who, when they call in, who is wonderful, who will be able to tell them at our practice. And she also fits the best person, the best therapist, with whatever their needs are, which is wonderful. And so they can give us a call anytime, right? We also do a lot of programs. And so if they go on our website, they can sign up for our mailing list, and that will notify them of some of the things that we're doing, including being at the Senior Summit. We'll be sending out newsletters that will be there. We do a lot of education for family caregivers.
Okay.
And instructing about disease process, helping them understand how to best handle if the individual has dementia, of whatever the disease is, but how to handle a dementia. Many of our programs for caregivers with for education are free, and we do some other programs that have sort of a nominal cost. We have a weekly program for mindfulness and yoga in our office every Friday at 10 o'clock, and we also are about to sponsor a brain health program, which is 2 days, two-hour programs, I should say, to teach people techniques on how to remember, and that's
keeping
all of
your
that
brain fit.
Mm-hmm.
And I say it over and over again.
That's a great technique.
When I'm going through the house, because what I find I do mm-hmm. is that I'm doing a task, and then something up comes, and if I don't do it, then I'll forget it. I mean, it's like making a phone call to my mom or mm-hmm. something like that. I gotta call mom, and I'll just keep saying it over and over so I remember. Mm-hmm. to do that after mm-hmm. I'm finished that task.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
If not, it's like I have tasks started and I don't get them done.
Right, mm-hmm. right.
So mm-hmm. that's frustrating. Mm-hmm. It's mm-hmm. just like, what's wrong with you?
Right.
And those are the types of techniques and a few more that we'll be teaching folks. But they can learn about this on our website and you know how to sign up for that. But yeah, we're really excited about some of the programs that we're offering as well.
Well, that's a good thing.
Yes.
Well, we're glad you girls came in today, and hopefully they'll come out to the summit and stop by your booth and say hi and look at some of the programs that you have to offer.
Absolutely.
Because it is something that is mm-hmm. a growing concern with mm-hmm. especially dementia. All you know, the people aren't sure of
right.
how long do I let this go, and is this just aging, or is
exactly.
there more going on? That's
exactly.
the main concern.
Exactly.
It's like, where do I look for help?
Where's that line?
Yeah.
You know, what do I need
mm-hmm.
to be concerned about?
And that's what we can help them with. Yeah. So we look forward to it. We're excited to meet a lot of new people and tell them about our services and how they can get in contact with us.
Well, thanks again for coming in.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, see you at the summit.
Absolutely.
Great. Thanks.
May 18th from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Queen Anne's County 4-H Park. Whee!